This tiny teach is about the viral plaque assay math. When you do your viral plaque assay, you're going to come back and you're going to look at your five plates. The first thing you want to do is figure out what plate you're actually going to use. You want to find the plate that has between 30 and 300 plaques. You're not looking for colonies, you're actually looking for plaques or areas of clearing on the plate. Once you figure out which plate to count, just count your plaques. Now, you're going to set up your math. For the math, you're going to take your plaque count times the virus dilution of the plate times 10. Now, you might be wondering why we're multiplying by 10. That's because we want to figure out PFU, or plaque forming units, per 1 milliliter of sample. When we started this viral plaque assay process, we took a tenth of a mil out of the 1 mil sample. We want to know how many plaques are in 1 mil of the sample, not how many are in a tenth of a mil. So we need to multiply by 10. Since we took out a tenth of a mil and we want to know how much is in 1 mil, we need to multiply by 10. So again, to set up your math, take your plaque count times the virus dilution times 10. So in my example, I have 113 for my plaque count. My virus dilution is 10 million, and then I'm multiplying by 10. The easiest way to do this is to take 113 and then just count up the zeros. So count up the zeros in 10 million and count up the zeros in 10 and just add them on to the end of 113. Now, when you look at a big number like that, you just need to remember, because it's been a while, that when you have a really large number, the decimal point is at the end of that really big number. When you do math in science, you always have to give us the number in scientific notation. Scientific notation means you have to give us a number between 1 and 9. This so far is not a number between 1 and 9. So what we need to do is we need to move that decimal point over until we have a number between 1 and 9. So we're just going to move that decimal point right on over until we get to a number between 1 and 9. So we're going to move it over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 places. So we would have 1.13 times 10 to the 10 PFU, or plaque forming units, per 1 milliliter of sample. This is a positive exponent because this was a very large number. You had a lot of viruses. You had a lot of viral plaques. So this should never be a negative exponent. Negative exponents are for very small numbers, not for very large numbers. So I thought we'd try one more again to set up your math. Plaque count times virus dilution times 10. To give us PFU per 1 mil of sample. So this time our plaque count is 89, our virus dilution is 1 million. We're gonna multiply that by 10. So take your 89, count up your zeros in your virus dilution and 10. So we have 6 zeros in our virus dilution of 1 million and 1 zero in our 10. So add 7 zeros onto your 89. Remember, in a big number, the decimal point is at the end, and then move your decimal point over. So in this case, we're going to move it over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 times, because we have to get a number between 1 and 9. So we would have 8.9 times 10 to the 8 PFU per 1 milliliter of sample.